G'day legends, welcome back to the garage. Not my garage, it's Mark's garage. Nice shirt, mate. How are you?
Good, mate.
Good.
Awesome.
Bit of a job today. We're going to install the INNOVV RC6 into the 890. It's going to be a bit of a job, and we're going to have a bit of fun. Mark's got some questions about how this thing's going to work, so we're going to go through some questions today. If you've got any questions as well, make sure you drop them down in the comments below. Subscribe to the channel, give us a big thumbs up, does help the channel. And today's job, mate, I reckon it's a good thing. What is it? It's 9:30 in the morning, so we've picked a pretty bloody good time to get stuck into it.
Awesome.
All right, we're going to pull the frames off, all the fairings off. It's going to be basically down the right hand side of the bike, so we'll make sure that we film as much as we can so you can see the install. Then we'll get out and test it. We'll have a chat about it and let's see how this goes. The INNOVV RC6, good unit. I like a dash cam. We've all seen my accident and I don't like always riding around with a like the Action 4 on the chin or anything. So having a dash cam and blind spot detection is going to be good on the road and off road as well. So good times indeed. All right, we'll get into it.
Righto, so with pulling this apart, Brett, so this is the front camera here.
Yep.
So where are we going to look and put this?
All right, so there's a couple of places I've got in my mind, and of course, theory's always good. We've got a bolt here, you've got a grommet here. Of course, we don't want it somewhere that, you know, as we're going over the dirt and everything, it's going to get smacked around, but it is going to get dirty. That's a given. So I was thinking around here, but also we've got the option of putting it on the outside of the lens there as well. So,
right. So we haven't got anywhere specific at this stage.
Nowhere at this stage. And that's, you know, we've got to look at that to consider where the wires are going to go as well.
How about this rear, mate?
All right. Now the rear one that I was thinking about, so I don't want to put it on
the rack,
just here. So if you look underneath here, there's a bit of room in there.
Oh, yeah.
And I was thinking if we undo these bolts here and then try and mount the rear one like that.
Yeah, she'll fit. Yep, not a gram.
It'll be out of the way of the light, but it also won't inhibit
we'll
anything
take this
there.
Lever panel off and we'll run it in with the other wiring.
All right.
Right, that's an easy one. This is the brains of the thing.
Yeah, so that will sit in here because as we take this off here, we've got, as we did with the Garmin when we installed that.
This is what we want. Yep.
We've got those, the grommets in there for the cabling.
Awesome, how good.
So, something that KTM's done pretty well is get things ready. There's some 3M tape that will go on there, and I don't know if we'll, you know, we'll look at it. It might actually go sideways, and then when we take this fairing off here, we might have to just cable tie.
Yep, too easy.
Get it up around there. Right. All right, we'll get these fairings off.
Okay.
All right, so with the front camera there, you can undo these two little screws, and it looks like an SD card, but they call it a TF card. So I'm going to look at the definition between the two, do a bit of a Google search, and we'll have a look. But they've given us a 32 gig card. I would prefer that 256. The bigger, the better.
100%. So we really haven't got any specs on how long a 256 card will.
And it will be 2.7K at 30 frames. Like a 32 gig card, I reckon you might maybe get, I don't know, maybe less than an hour to an hour.
Yeah.
But until we test it, we don't know.
That's right.
But the 256 gigs will give us a fail safe. So at least then we can get stacks of footage on it.
Yeah.
But the idea is if you have an accident or you see something, you pull over or if you're, the bike's on the ground, you can download it straight to the INNOVV app.
Okay.
The instructions they give us here, they're pretty extensive. Actually, I'm going to get you to spread them out. Because when I saw these, when I opened the box up, I was like, oh, yeah. So I spread them out a bit more. Open it right up.
Oh, it actually opens up more.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Keep going.
All right.
So right. When we're done with this, I might be able to use it for Christmas paper. So I've got all the details on the app, the install, goes where. It's really good. So I think being that the company that INNOVV is, they'll really set it up so that you can pretty much do this yourself.
Awesome. How good.
Yeah.
Righto.
All right.
Let's do it.
Let's get into it. Cool.
The hardware for this is unreal. They have given you absolutely everything. All stainless fittings, as expected.
Hang on, just loosen up a bit again because it's moved it around a smidge.
There's more than one way of putting the system together.
Go.
Ready?
Yep, go for it. Tighten her up.
Let's get my socket, mate. So you're happy with the height?
Yeah, that height's perfect.
Right, well, I'll nip that up.
All right.
So, you know, what they've given you is all the stainless steel fittings, your flat washer and a spring washer.
Right, there you go. And,
there's no real way anything's going to move.
This is going to be brilliant.
Drop anything and lose anything.
Yeah.
But they've given you more than what you need with this kit.
Yeah. No, this is looking great.
I'm impressed.
I'm going to muck around with this here. Oh, just squeeze in front. So perfectly with this radar, I like to try and put it up here. If you look carefully there, we're going to try and put the camera and the radar right there, and the lights should not affect that lens whatsoever. So that's the cunning plan with that. At least I've got that on there. I'll have a look at what these fittings are to remove that tail, because that's so solid. Doing all right so far. We've been at it for an hour. Do you want me to hold that?
It shouldn't have been this hard.
Okay, not going to lie, it's been a bit of a challenge, and we're always up for a challenge, especially when it comes to Mark's garage. What do you reckon?
Yeah, it was good challenge, that one.
All right.
What it was, easy. This bolt goes through, or this it screws both sides, that holds the top of the headlight shroud. But it was spinning. There's no way of locking this in. There's no tabs to lock this end in. So you've kind of got it there, and it's pot luck that it undoes. So what I've done is we've got it out. I'll put a couple of slots in. So either way, later on, I'll hold it with a screwdriver and lock it up. So that was the issue.
Right.
So we're down to the last screw.
Which was in there.
In here. And we've now got the headlight out. So we can do this wiring for this.
Yeah, we're going to put the sensors in there, just see what that looks like. That's quite a challenge, isn't it? All right.
Oh, too easy.
Cool. All right. We'll keep going and get this sorted out. Back in a minute. All right. So while Mark's doing his thing, I'm going to figure out where these pieces are going to go.
So it'll be on positive negative
all
the time, but it only activates and turns on when your ignition comes on, which gets picked up on this one.
Right. Look out here.
I'll just fucking heat you up.
I won't put those on. I won't stick those on until I know indefinitely where they're going.
Okay, what we're doing, we're going to do a bit of a test. Just checking our accessories, positive, negative. That's accessories, turn the key off. Right, no power. So that's definitely right. This here is positive negative, and this should be on all the time, ignition off. So we go, that is positive. Positive.
Let me get it in there. Famous last words.
I don't have any dramas.
Let's see if I can do this properly without totally botching it up. Nothing behind it. Oh, God, I'm good at making holes.
Just nice and soft, mate. Nice and easy. Top one looked like it was a big one as well. No, this is it here. No, that's it. So can you? That's it. That's it there. That's
got it.
That's got it.
Okay, so. I'll just put this one in here and I'll turn the power. I don't know if that's all good.
Right,
while you're doing that, I might go and grab a couple of sandwiches.
All right, legends. So the install is still going on. Mark's put the headlight back on. He's done an epic job doing that one there. All the cameras are installed. Okay, so we're going to follow the instructions here, and I apologize that I'm not looking at you directly. I've just opened up the Innovv app. Looks like a great app. Okay, there's our settings now. Okay, so camera video. Is it going to connect? How good does that look? Oh my, that's even with the covers on. Photos. Holy moly. That's looking really, really cool. That is so clear. Strength. Okay, I'm going to go into the settings. And let's have a look at the Innovv settings. This is brilliant. I'm really, really excited about this. So I've got all the passwords there, and I'll change all those so that you buggers can't get into it. Wi-Fi active. Yep, cool. Camera settings. Let's go in there. Excellent. 2.7K. That's looking really good at 30 frames. Bit rate is high. Orientation is normal. Loop recording duration 1 minute. I might extend that, make it a 3. Preview default front and right audio level 2. We'll leave it at that. Date and time. Watermark text Innovv. Card capacity. I can format it. I might do that now, actually. Accept. And it's going to detect that. It's got a G sensor as well. Wow, this is amazing. This is really cool. Update time. Accept. Advanced settings. I might bring the G sensor up a little bit higher. We've got a lot to learn about this. This is just the install. We'll go out and do a test ride in due course as well. There's everything there. I'm really chuffed with this. This looks great. And you can see on the phone, it is crystal clear. And considering that I've got the lights on the back there, I can't wait to try the detection, the rear detection, to see how that goes as well. Anyhow, we're going to clean up. We're going to get stuck into just tidying up, putting everything on and getting it all together. And then we shall see. Sorry, I'm hearing things, and I know around Mark's place they get red-bellied blacks and browns. And I hate snakes. Awesome. All right, I'm really stoked with that. That's brilliant. All right, so we'll finish it off. We'll get the bike back together and then go from there. Pretty happy with that. This is outstanding. I'll even...
You've got...
That one's all in there. I've put that one in there on the side.
But I've been double checking. Have you hidden?
One, two. Oh, we'll go around with the torch in a minute and have a look. I'll put the cleaner here. There it is. I'll just give this a quick wipe. All right, that's all in. Do that.
Nice.
Nicely tucked in everywhere. Thank you. No, that was awesome. All right, so got the unit set up. What time do we start? It was 9:30. That's 4 hours. That's nothing. 4 hours, a bit of a lunch break, and going mad with that rod. If anyone's got an 890 and you've got to take the headlight out, there's a rod in there that was giving us a bit of grief. But that was pretty much it. But other than that,
That there was probably an hour, and we pulled off more than what we had to.
Yeah.
So really, it'd be start to finish.
Oh, it'd be two hours?
Two and a half hours, really.
Yeah, right.
Or less.
Yeah, cool. All right. Well, we did all right.
Yeah.
You did all right.
There'd be four hours for one person.
It looks like it works. We've checked the app out. It connects all up, which is great, and I'll do a full rundown. But the install itself, that's done and dusted. And I think it looks pretty neat. Now I'll go for a roll around with the camera so you can have a quick look. So there's your front camera here. And no, it doesn't bang the guard, the front fender, and the front fender's fixed, so we're not going to have any incidents there. That works out pretty well. Then up the top here, we've got the blind spot detection sensor or indicators left and right, which is great, and that's going to be right in my view. And then the rear camera is all sorted. Look at that. That was pretty schmick. So, and the radar, because that's what that big square thing is there. So I'll go for a ride, test it out, and see what that's like. Go and have a bit of fun with that. But legend, thank you.
No worries, mate.
Too bloody easy. Champion.
Yeah, my pleasure.
I don't know what I'd do without you and your man cave. Because I certainly...
I don't know what I'd do
without
my man cave.
Yeah, I know, right? Look at it. It's gorgeous. If you guys haven't seen the Thruxton yet, here it is. But Mark does get out. Have you got a couple of videos now on the Thruxton? I think you do, don't you?
No, I've got nothing.
You got nothing. All right. Well, maybe one day... Oh, what do you reckon the sticker kit? That's some thick stuff right there. I like it. You reckon it's too busy? I like it. I think it's wild. It's cool. But yeah, there's a fair bit going on. We've got a few rides lined up. Stick around. Subscribe to the channels. Don't forget Throttle Riding Adventures. Jump onto Mark's channel. His link's down below, plus the Facebook page. And have you done anything with your Instagram yet? He's the garage man. I'm the social media guru. So we'll get his Instagram up and running. You can follow that as well. And yeah, we'll have a bit of fun. All right. Uru for now. Ride safe. Stay left. This is it. I thought I'd tell you all about the INNOVV RC6 now installed on the bike. Yeah, this 2.7K camera, both front and rear, brilliant. Now, the other thing I want you to keep an eye out for, I haven't got anyone behind me at the moment, but up here on the top right and up here on the top left, two little indicators, and those little indicators are part of the blind spot detections, the radar sitting under the tail, just above the number plate there. That's also got a camera attached to it, but that blind spot detection will detect someone like right here or right here, where I can't really see them at all. So it's brilliant. I was using it this morning in the dark. It worked very, very well. I was very happy with it. So, but now that we've got a bit of light, it is late in the afternoon. What is it, nearly 6:30? So we're gonna, yeah, head home, and I wanna demonstrate it to you guys so you can have a look at what it's like. Yes. All right, got some cars coming up behind me. We're gonna go into some higher traffic areas. There you go, see the indication there on the right? This blind spot detection is quite effective. Right now in the camera, I've got a 32 gig card. I am upgrading that to most likely a 256 gig card. And I'll keep that in there, format that, get that ready to go. So there's your light. That works really well. I like it. I like it a lot. Love the idea as well that I won't need to ride with cameras all the time, because I've got the dash cam sitting in the bike as it is, fully installed, ready to rock and roll. Because there are days where I just like to go for a ride, but I want that coverage. Like something I learned from the accident that I had was that having that camera footage is a bit of a lifesaver. I've also got a dash cam in the Amarok as well, but this INNOVV RC6 is really something to consider on your bike. And INNOVV does some amazing camera systems just for motorbikes. You should have a look at it. Definitely well worth it. So you'll see it in action. The footage is pretty spectacular. It's very easy to get the footage off the bike because the module actually sits underneath the seat, and then you just download it onto your phone through the Wi-Fi, and it is actually quite quick. Something I learned today, because my Wi-Fi wasn't connecting, on the camera itself it's got a little white button, and you press that little white button a couple of times, the Wi-Fi kicks up and you can connect it, which I like the idea of as well. The one thing I wish it did have, which I've had on previous cameras when I had the twin, sorry, I just want to make sure that lens isn't too filthy, is this sentry alert. So if someone wants to come and fiddle around with your bike and they move it or do something silly with it, then it's on a loop record. So it will catch them if they're moving it. But, you know, that's okay. I usually don't go too far from the bike if I'm out and about. I like to stay within arm's reach, within view of it. Yeah, so these cameras are pretty good, and Teapot One's had a series of them on the GS's that he's had, and I love what I saw there. The comparison footage to other cameras I've used in the past, I think the Innovv just speaks for itself. And that's, you know, it's such a good unit. So we're going to get out and test it. So we've done the install, thanks for watching that, and getting out on the road and getting a feel for it now. But I'll give you a short-term and a long-term review. I like sending a bit of footage out to some of the Dashcam video YouTube channels, so you might see some out there. And I might even put some up here in some shorts, because they're always good fun to watch as well. So keep an eye out on that. Subscribe to the channel. Make sure you like the video, share it around as well. All right, I'm going to continue the ride home. We'll see what kind of footage we can get out of the Innovv RC6. Make sure you check out the website, have a look, and we'll talk more about it in future videos. We'll take it out on the bush as well and see how it fares out in the mud and the sticks. Be good, ride safe, and stay left, will ya? Uru for now.